A valuable product lies buried in the hills surrounding Anyi, for it is there that underground deposits of salty brine lay hidden. If the brine is pumped to the surface and evaporated in kettles under big fires, the product is crystallized salt. Surely it is a gift from the dragon. It is past time for the government to take control of this lucrative industry so that more people can enjoy the delicious flavor that salt adds to the daily meal. Go to Anyi, locate the salt deposits, and construct salt mines. Open trade with the distant cities of the Zhou Kingdom, for most have already acquired a taste for salt that is not easily satisfied. Ceramics and bronze can be imported from Hao, for the hills of Anyi, though rich in many ways, lack these commodities.
Hey guys, welcome back to Emperor Rise of the Middle Kingdom. We're here on the salt mines of Anyi, Turbulent Winds. And looks like it's gonna be an economical mission. Produce 28 canisters of salt in a year, yearly profit of 1,500, and treasury of 13,000. That doesn't seem too hard, considering some of our previous missions. Anyway, we're playing on difficulty level very hard, and just as a bit of a tweak, I'm no longer running, well, I've upped the resolution to maximum 1080p. So hopefully this looks okay, but it means that on the map itself, as you can see here, we should be seeing a lot more of the map. Well, at least a little bit more of the map, honestly. Anyway, let's see what we got here. We have this river, and it looks like this is stuff on the map. What is all this? Salt marsh. The marsh can be mined for salt. It contains a vital part of a healthy diet. Only salt mines and roads can be built here. Alright, so only salt mines and roads. So here we go, salt mines. They're placed directly onto this stuff. Okay, we can do that. So what else do we have? In terms of food, we have farms, and we can get cabbage and millet. And then we have hunter's tents for these pheasants, I guess. So we got pheasants there, and I think a lot more pheasants here. But salt counts as a food, I think. So, does that mean pheasants plus salt equals two types of food already? Because that would be very good. And also, let's go to the Empire map and have a look at what we have here. We're here in Anyi, and we're currently trading with Anyang, which buys wood, game meat, carved jade. Khufu, bronzeware, salt, millet. Okay, so we can sell salt and game meat straight away. We could sell millet as well, but I'm not sure if we're going to be getting that. Anyway, Wu, Hao, Pingyang, Shu, and the Nomad Camps, I'm not too sure. We don't start with a lot of money on this mission, so I probably shouldn't just go out trying to sell things. I should probably start selling to Anyang and Khufu first. So salt and game meat are going to be what we're selling. So, since all the food seems to be over on this side, our residential blocks should go somewhere on this side as well. There's also these salamanders, which we gotta avoid. But how do we get up this hill? I think I gotta rotate to see. Okay, these are the ramps right here. So if we're building the residential area on this side, the closest ramp that actually leads up is here. There, right? And then it goes up here, and then it goes up here into the salt mines. Okay, so let me just rotate back. It's here. It's so hard to see. I should build this road first so I can actually see what I'm doing. So this needs to go around like that. That needs to clear off like that. And this needs to clear down that way. So it's gonna look... Oh, I gotta clear this as well. Gotta cut through the trees a little bit. And now when I rotate back to this, I like to stay in the north view, but we can at least see where the road goes. Okay, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna set up the residential areas here so we can get our game meat from there, and then it's gonna extend down this way to the salt mines, and that's pretty much all the industry we need. We can do logging shed as well. Can we sell wood? Anyang buys wood as well, so wood, game meat, and salt. Our priorities at the start. Okay, so that sounds like a plan, and let's get things started. All right, would you look at that? I've set up these two residential areas here in this sort of a slightly shorter rectangular block because this time I want to put the marketplace outside, the market square rather, and we do need more workers, yes, waiting for people to move in. Anyway, this area seems pretty nicely developed. This area, it's a bit close to those rocks for feng shui purposes, but overall, it's going okay. I put down one hemp farm, here's our hunter's tents, and there's the logging sheds, and here's gonna be the commercial sort of distribution area with a trading station to Anyang for game meat and wood, a mill getting game meat, millet, and salt, and this is gonna be accepting the hemp. So once people start moving in, which should be soon enough, yes, so we're gonna speed the game up here, and I'm gonna prioritize safety to very high, and Agriculture is so high. I guess I'll set that to high because that's our food supply and that's gonna help our houses evolve. Now, I don't know if these salamanders are gonna cause any problems. Hopefully not, but once people move in, we'll see if we actually have enough people to, these pheasants are everywhere, to actually start a salt industry. Because this road is gonna extend down this way and I'm not sure how best to arrange the salt mines, but it's looking good. So we're just gonna wait till these people move in. Hopefully nothing burns down in the meantime. Let's just speed things along, get people moving in, get the safety buildings going. Oh, safety buildings include the herbalist stall. I'll turn that off for now. And I'll turn this off for now as well. You can see I put down the acupuncturist clinic, but it's not working right now. I just want to make sure all of our safety buildings are actually employed first. So nothing actually burns down. Oh no, there we go. Things do burn or collapse pretty quick. Are we sending someone out? Okay, let's hope this guy actually reaches these buildings in time. Oh no! That is not good. We're gonna have to put down a second inspector's tower. Let's quickly get that going. I'll have to rebuild those logging sheds. And the mill, damn it! I calculated it correctly, but that salamander got in the way. Come on, send someone out. Save these buildings. Okay, there we go. Now things are starting to get going. And these salamanders are gonna cause some problems. I think maybe if I put down a watchtower, it will actually deal with the salamanders. We'll see. But until then, those inspectors are gonna have to die. Alright, it looks like these guys do actually deal with the salamanders, so that's good. Because we don't want these salamanders here at all, so at least with one sentry patrolling, it's gonna be good. Meanwhile, it seems like I kinda need a second inspector's tower here, because that guy doesn't quite reach anyway, so it's all good. So, we finally got some exports going of the game meat and the wood. You can see there, money is starting to come in. It's not the best things to sell, it's not the most valuable, but it gets us started. Now, we put down even more hunter's tents so we can actually start overproducing meat, so we can actually start feeding our people. And this house here burnt down to the ground, so we gotta deal with that. And it seems like they're going across the river to hunt those pheasants as well. Meanwhile, I put down this little wall here to limit the number of salamanders wandering over, but generally when they wander over, they might kill a woodworker or two, but they tend to run into a sentry or a hunter like that, and the hunters can kill them, no problem. You can see that. I'm trying to figure out how to limit this even further, but I can't build a wall across this little stream. So I might have to figure something out there. Meanwhile, the wood supply seems to be coming in enough to sell, enough for the year. So we shouldn't have to expand that. And I set my my wages to very high, so we actually have... Wait, where did we get all that unemployment? Let's pause the game. Since we have unemployment, we can start our salt industry. Let's go ahead and squeeze in some salt mines. Now, the road is here. So let's... How many people does it need? 17 people. We could put down a few of these. It's got to be completely on the... Okay. How do we do this? We could expand that way or expand this way. I think expanding this way might be better. Yeah, we could do... Let's put down three like that. And we're going to have this road come around this way. And it's going to come around this way. And connect up to that. Okay, good. So there is a salamander here as well, which is not ideal. Can I go ahead and trap this somehow? Let's see if I can actually take a tan wall. Oh, I can't. Ah, damn it. I can't trap that salamander. So it might be a bit of an issue there. But we do need to keep these buildings standing. So let's find a good place for our... Let's go to those trees. Inspector's Tower can go right there. Roadblock right here, I guess. Yeah, roadblock right there. So the inspector will take care of those buildings. Now, the reason... Well, salt is gonna go into that mill as well, but I do need to have a bit of a trade industry going as well. So I'd like to... Can I fit a trade building? Like there? I don't think it'll fit there. Because I'm looking at the trading station to Khufu. I think it might just about fit. I don't know if it's gonna be good feng shui though. It is not good feng shui. Maybe if I get rid of all the trees, will that actually be good feng shui? No, it's not. Okay, I'm gonna have to find a spot for the trading station with Khufu. I'm not sure exactly what they like. They like stones? Okay, so I want to put the trading station up here because Khufu buys salt. So we definitely want to sell that. But any extra, we want to send it down to that mill. Alright, so I've actually gone into debt here, but the food supply has come through with the salt and the meat. And it seems like salt, having to be carried so far, it's sort of limiting the amount of supply, but it seems like when the food shop takes the salt, well, it only takes one, very little in comparison to the amount of meat anyway. So it seems like we don't need to have too much salt here. So over here I said it's accepting 4 salt, so there is some salt coming over, but I do need to boost my, salt production so we actually get more going out of the city, because we need to start making money at this point. I also put down this tax collector's office with this administrative city here, so we start collecting taxes from these evolved houses, and they need appetizing food before they can evolve any further. Oh, it seems like all the salt's been taken up. And just as I was saying, they don't take as much. Oh, they take less salt compared to meat, but what they are selling now is savory double cooked meat. Sounds tasty actually. And so right now, I just have to up my salt production, so I can put one there. And I could put another here. I'm not sure if... Inspector's Tower will reach that far, but this looks good, putting down 2 more. So that should boost enough salt production to keep that filled to 4, and also to start putting some in here. And it seems like... Oh, is this... Returning to trading station from mill. So he's actually taking the salt from the mill to put into the trading station. It wasn't actually consumed by the city. So I suppose that's okay, I guess. Because this isn't set to getting, I set it to accepting. So I guess the trading station can go ahead and take it. I'm not sure if we're gonna sell any though. Wait, is it? No, it is a land trade route, right? To Khufu? Yeah, it's a land trade route. We don't need a dock. Where are the Khufu traders? How about you? This is... Yeah, okay. Are these traders gonna go down that way? We can drop our wages, because we're actually getting unemployment. I wanna see if these traders actually walk down towards... Yes, they are. Okay, so Khufu traders are coming to buy salt, so that's gonna get us some money. I'm not sure how much, because currently we're at 800 in debt, and we gotta start making money. So dropping our wage rate and starting to tax the people is actually a good idea. Let's see how much salt actually makes. Let's just get these Khufu traders over. And a building has collapsed. Oh, okay, that is slightly out of reach. Now let's see, how much money does it make here? Not that much, honestly. I might have to find something a bit more valuable to sell, but at least this should keep us afloat. Oh no, I forgot something. I always forget religion. The gods are now unhappy. So, what I'm doing is I'm upping my hemp production, which shouldn't be a problem because we have plenty of unemployment. And lots of hemp does come in with each round, so I'm just waiting for a month to pass, and so now is October, because I gave a bit of hemp, and I also expanded, 5 canisters of salt for how within 5 months. Okay, that's going to be a little tricky. I did boost my salt production by 3 more mines over to the side there, and let's, I still can't give a gift to the gods. Okay, how do we do this? We got to start stockpiling salt then. Let's, start stockpiling that and wait for more salt to come in. We're having difficulty getting out of debt though, which is a little tricky. I'm not sure if we're gonna be able to handle this, but maybe I could start sending, I don't know, even sending gifts costs money, so I'm not sure if we're gonna be able to do that. We should probably up the amount of salt we can hold in here. Let's up it to 8. And then that should allow one more to go in, which means we should be able to send it off. It was to Hao, right? Fulfill the city's request? Yes. Dispatch goods. There we go. So we don't actually have to start stockpiling it. That's fine. So, can I now give a gift to the gods? Yes. Okay, we do have hemp. So let's get Nuwa happy first with a medium offering of hemp. Neglected. It's gonna have to do. So hopefully we start oversupplying hemp, and then we can get the gods happy again. Alright, I actually could not get out of debt, so I had to reload back to a ways away to redo something, because I realized I need to really focus on exports. And as the briefing stated, we need to start exporting to Hao and Pingyang salt, and basically what that means is we cannot use salt here, so we need to get have another way to get the types of food that we need. So I went ahead and put down these two farms here, and this is something I forgot to do in the previous mission, splitting up the crops on each farm so that it sort of staggers the workload, because you never really fully cover a field anyway. And oh, I forgot. I completely forgot to put down my hemp fields over here, but I'm kind of short on cash anyway. So this is where I go into debt, but this time it's going to be different. The food supply is going to be much more steady with 3 types of food, with the game meat, the cabbages, and the millet. And our exports are going to focus over here as we build these salt mines. As the employees go up, we'll start getting more salt, and it's going to be dedicated to exports only. And as that builds up, we're going to be able to sell to Hao and Pingyang as well. So, major exports are going to be salt from over here. No more carrying salt all the way over to this side of the city. And we're going to focus on making money more than anything. With this food supply, looks like it's actually going really well, the number of cabbages and millet fields that we're developing here. So, this should be a better plan. We'll see if we can actually stabilize our money from this. Alright, so I finally figured out how to get my money stabilized. You really do need all 3 salt trading locations open. Pingyang, Hao, and Kufu. So if you see, I've actually regressed a little bit further. No administrative city, no taxes, because it just, I did not want to do deficit spending. And also reduced the farms by 1, because you only needed 1 actually to really keep this filled. I mean, we got plenty of food. Look at that, 3 types of food, solid. So 1 farm is actually fine for millet and cabbages. And I didn't even spend money on getting our population up. We could do with a few more people. Now that we have a bit more going for us, we drop down a few more gardens like that and it evolves. And we could also go ahead and give them music while we're at it. Okay, so now that we're at this point, we're actually going up in money. So for the first time, actually. And we have already sold pretty much everything for this year, so I don't think I can build anything until next year. But if we look at our goals, we've actually hit one already. We produced 43 canisters of salt in a year, which is way more than what we actually needed. Next is yearly profit and our treasury to 13,000. So we just have to make money at this point. We don't actually need to evolve our houses or anything like that. And would you look at that? Hao is willing to trade more salt from me. So I think this is where things really get going. so we can sell up to 24 canisters of salt to Hao. Okay, so this is where we need to focus on increasing our salt output. I mean, technically, if we look at this, best is 43. We're doing 12, 12, 24, 24 times 2 is 48. So actually, we should almost be producing enough for the whole year anyway, but we'll see if we actually can. I think a couple more salt mines would be good just for stability's sake. Hey, would you look at that? Because of the reduced supplies throughout the world, the price of salt has risen by the amount shown above. Importing the good is now costlier, but higher profits can be made by exporting it. So, finally, it just turned a new year, so we have some traders coming along, and we're gonna start making some bank on salt now that the prices have gone up. So let's see how much this actually makes us. And just waiting for this trader to reach, which one is he going for? That one? That is worth a lot more than before. This is gonna be fantastic. Now that we can actually sell salt for something worthwhile, and we're selling so much of it, the fact that the price has gone up means we now have money. All right, that's great. Oh no, the ancestors are angry and their fury causes the earth to quake. Your city is in peril. Oh no, this is bad. The gods aren't unhappy or angry or anything. This is just like that flood thing. Where is it shaking? Right here? Is that actually gonna affect anything? One building catches fire. Oh, that's fantastic. Here is where shook. I didn't build anything there. Oh, okay. Easy. Oh, this collapsed though. So we gotta rebuild that salt mine. Anything else collapsed? No, that's it. Okay, good. And I put down a few more gardens, so these areas are evolving now as well. I don't want to put down too many. I put down the administrative city and started taxing people, but I'm still trying to stay above board this time around. All right, so I put down another tax collector here, and it did seem to increase my overall tax rate, but according to this, I'm not collecting any taxes from here. But, does it actually say how much money this place has collected? I don't think so. But just looking at it, I'm collecting 1,600 in cash from taxes, and our payroll is slightly less than that. So we're actually making money from this, and we could even drop our wages even further. So you can see our money is actually going up, and look at all of this salt. I put down two more salt mines down there, and it's increased our production to 56 a year, maybe a little bit more, which is very good, slightly more than what we need, because quite often the cities are asking for gifts of salt, which is no problem. We can send that off pretty easily. Meanwhile, I'm still giving hemp to populations reach 2,000. Nice. We're still giving gifts of hemp to all the gods to keep them neglected anyway. Not exactly keeping them happy. I don't find the gods too useful this time around. But for some reason, our meat production... I know that the first time we were going through this, our meat production seemed to be a little bad. But it seems like this time around, we're actually keeping meat much better. Or maybe it's because we actually got three types of food instead of two. So the markets are consuming less meat, I guess? Now we could feed this area, but it really is unnecessary. We have unemployment and our wages are already very low. So it's already gonna be fine. So right now, looking at our goals, we just need to make a yearly profit, which I think this year is the biggest year so far, so we should be able to hit that, and get our treasury to 13,000. And that's just a matter of time. Alright, so another year has passed, and we're now at 5,000, approaching 6,000 cash. We are gaining a little bit every month, and we've hit our second target. Looks like we earn about 2,500 to 3,000 a year, depending on a couple variables, but depending on if we actually spend any money. So, that rate is a little low. I mean, I don't know if we could up it any. I mean, we could sell more game meat, kind of. We can't make silk, we can't make weapons. We're already selling that. We could sell carved jade there, but do people... Okay, I could import jade from Khufu and sell carved jade to Anyang. I mean, that's one option, right? But we're also not trading with Wu. Let's send a diplomatic request to open trade with Wu and see if... And even the nomad camps. Let's send a diplomatic request to the nomad camps. Shu, I don't think... Oh, I can actually. Let's open up the trade routes. Earlier, I couldn't open up Shu, but let's open see what they want and see if there's actually a way to make money faster, because right now, we just have to get our money to 13,000 and we win. So, I actually got Shu to open up trading with me, and I don't know why I couldn't open trading with them before. I did try clicking on them, but it didn't give any options, but maybe something changed. Anyway, they opened up for trading and they buy 24 canisters of salt, which is fantastic. So I can actually, I was overproducing quite a bit. So let's drop the amount we're storing in these other places. I set this one to maximum, allowing up to 60 into there, because, well, if there's any surplus, it just goes to the furthest one. That's my logic here. Anyway, we can now start selling another 24 canisters of salt a year, which is definitely gonna boost the speed at which we're making money. Well, we're almost there actually, so by next year we should be able to make it. Alright, so we're actually almost at our target here. Let's slow the game down so I can see what's going on. And also, Shu, there was no notice or anything, but I'm pretty sure this said 24... earlier, right? Well, it now says 36, so we can pretty much sell all that we need. We're producing about 80 canisters a year, so we should quite easily, yeah, we can earn 3,000 a year, so we should quite easily hit our target very, very soon. We just need a bit more cash. Let's just speed things along. We're at 11,000. We need 13,000. Oh, damn it, there's a salamander in the way. It's just gonna walk through all of this, I guess. Come on, don't die to the salamander. Damn it! I hate how we can't deal with these salamanders. I mean, I guess I could have built some infantry, but I had to import weapons to deal with that. Anyway, let's we lowered the tax rate earlier to keep people happy. But now, why is our tax lower than before? I don't know. Oh, now it says 24. I'm sure it said 36 just now, right? Maybe just for that 1 year it was 36, I guess? We've sold all of that. It might take one more year before we hit our goal, actually. And here we go, who wants it? How wants it? Okay, go ahead, have some. Does it actually take out of the How trading station? It does. Well, that's nice. We're at 12,000, we just need another 1,000 more. Are we selling anything else this year? We've fully sold there. We've sold there, sold out there, sold out there, sold out there. Wait, no, this is now 36 again. I don't know what's up with that number, but I don't know if another 12 is gonna be enough to bring it up another 1,000. Let's find out. Is there another shoe? We're looking for another shoe trader. They're the ones who wear red, I think. These guys. Speed it along, and let's not celebrate, that costs money. We have plenty of hemp, let's make sure the gods maintain neglected with great offerings of hemp. It's actually going up to contented now, it's slowly climbing. People are objecting to high taxes, the taxes are just normal, they're not even high. Look at all this salt. Alright, are we gonna get 1,000 from these two caravans? Because if we do, then we're gonna win. I think it's gonna be a bit short. It's so close. Is that another? Hey, we did it!
Humble
yes!
Administrator, your dexterity at managing the many aspects of a thriving city is only surpassed by your good sense of business savvy. Government control of this lucrative product will help to ensure the longevity of the mighty Zhou dynasty.
So, there you have it, the salt mines of Anyi. And I don't know what gave us that little boost of cash right at the end there. It is a new year, maybe the other trading post, maybe? Or something? I don't know, but We finally managed to do it. We had to reload at one point because we didn't focus enough on exports. I should learn not to do that and not to expand too quickly. Sometimes you just have to wait a couple years. Anyway, that's it for now. Hope you enjoyed it. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.